Welcome to my YouTube channel. Let's start with new video. In my previous video, I was telling you about the present tense. And in the present tense, we were discussing the first part of this tense. This is present indefinite tense. Present indefinite. Here, indefinite represents something uncertain. Because this is the tense in which you can't say exactly that the action has done or not. That's all up to you. I like you knew that what is the definition of present indefinite tense, right? Which action and which time we express in this tense, right? Not only that, but also I was telling you that if your subject is I, we, you, they, plural noun, so which subject and helping verb you can use to express your action in the present indefinite tense and to frame sentence. And if your subject is he, she, it, name and third person singular noun, so which verb and helping verb you have to use. When you make any affirmative sentence and you express your action in time, in affirmative, interrogative, negative and interrogative negatives, right? We apply all formulas, right? I have already told you about the present indefinite that which formula, which verb, which helping verbs we can use, but it has not finished yet. Yes, dear student, there is a lot more to know about the present indefinite that it can express many things. What? Habitual action, permanent action, routine action, historical fact, universal things, dramatic narratives, existence, position, and series of events, commentaries, quotations, lot more are there. Stay with me.
Usage of present indefinite tense. How I can express action and things in time in present indefinite. See, I can express permanent actions like I live in Shimla. Independence Day falls on 15th of August. These are the permanent things. These are the permanent action which I can express in present indefinite tense, right? To express routine actions, what are my routine actions? I get up at 9 a.m. My father goes to office at 9 a.m. I continue my study for 3 hours. He complete his homework in the morning, right? Side by side, you can notice subject, verb and helping verb as well. Now, to express habitual actions, whenever you are expressing your habitual actions, so in such sentences, we make use of adverbs of frequencies like always, often, sometimes, never, seldom, generally, regularly, usually, rarely, normally, etc. Like, she always comes late. He never comes on time. They rarely tell a lie. He seldom invites his friend. See, we can express universal truth like milk is white. The sun rises in the east. The failures are the pillars of success, right? A molecule of the water consists of 2 atoms of hydrogen and 1 atom of oxygen, right? These are universal truths. And to express planned future action or firm decision and programs, right? Whenever you are expressing such sentences and such action, right? At that time, we will use adverb of time like tomorrow, next time, next week, next day, next month, next year, etc. Like, she gets married next year. The plane takes off at 10 a.m. Right? I leave for Delhi tomorrow. We sail for England next month. Right? We are appropriately using the subject, helping verb and verb in these sentences. Right? Now, we can express position and ownership like how? I have a car. He holds a powerful post. He owns a palatial building. She belongs to a well-to-do family are some examples in which we can express our positions and ownership. Yes, dear student, I want to tell you one very important thing that you do not get confused with the action that I'm telling you. Right? We can express permanent action. We can express habitual action. We can express some series of commentaries and event and present positions, etc. See, while I'm telling you all these things At the same time, we are following the subject verb, helping verb, and every formula which we apply for the formation of sentences in present indefinite, whether it is affirmative, negative, interrogative, or interrogative negative sentences. Just keep these things in your mind while we are discussing and while we are talking all these things, while we are expressing our different actions in different way. Keep your eyes on the subject, that which subject we are using, right? At the same time, first form of the verb and helping verb will be according to the subject. See these series of example which will let you know about the action. We can express historical events and facts. And whenever we express historical events and facts in the present time, it gives the sense of past time. Like India becomes free in 1947. The Battle of Panipat begins in 1526. Mahatma Gandhi dies in 1948 are such example. And expressing the quotation as well. Right? Keats says, beauty is to see, not to touch. Shelley says, if winter comes, can spring be far behind? Okay, Vacan says, some books are to be tested, some are to be swallowed, and some are to be chewed and digested. Okay, to express commentaries and series of events, like Kohli begs 4 runs more, Rahul passes the ball to Yuvraj, Bumrah begs 5 wickets in this match are some example. Now, we also can express so much, like to express a subordinate clause of time and condition introduced by if, till, when in a conditional sentences. Okay, conditional sentences mein agar if, till, when se shuru hota hai koi bhi clause, right, there we can make use of it. Like, I shall stay here till you come back. You come back. Okay, when you reach there, send me a letter. If you give me blood, I will give you freedom. If you violate the rules of the road, you will be fined. So here again, I can let you know that we can express situation, existent position in the present. How? I am not in a fix. Here, see, I am not in a fix. How it is working as a verb here. The passengers are safe. The TV is on, but light is off. Lord Rama is an ideal personality. These are some examples. I hope you will understand. Expressing the dramatic narratives, right? Like Rana Pratap now draws his sword and attacks on the enemy, right? Immediately the police arrives to the place of occurrence, right? When the curtain rises, Macbeth is seen sitting on his throne. Right, Sohrab now rushes forward and gives a heavy blow to the Rostam. Right, to begin imperative sentences like obey the traffic rules, never tell a lie, help the poor, always speak the truth. Yes, dear student, let me tell you something more about present indefinite tense here. We can express newspaper headlines like extremist kill 50, Mr. Himta resigns, NTPC cut supply, Dr. Kalam takes oath. See the verb and helping verb in these example, right? Now move on. It is very important here, right? This is simple present here, right? Jiska use present continuous tense ke badle mein, right, verb ke saath waise hi kiya jata hai, jinka prayog samanya to continuous form mein nahi kiya jata hai. Like the verbs of perception. Ye perception ki kuch verb hai which we only can use in the present indefinite, right? I will let you know later. These are hear, notice, see, smell, recognize. And verbs of possessions. These are belong, contain, own, possesses, consist of. Verb of appearing, appear, look, seem. And verbs of emotion. These are the desire, feel, hate, hope, love, refuse, want, wish, like, prefer. Verbs of thinking are there. Think, suppose, understood, agree, believe, consider, forget, knew, mean, imagine, mind, remembers are some word which is very important, which we only can use in present indefinite very effectively with the verb. Let me clear the concept to you. There are some example. I'm having a car. Do you think that this is right and correct? I have a car is correct, Right? I'm thinking he's honest. Is it correct? No. I think he is honest. She is looking sad. Wrong again. She looks sad. Right? A child is liking sweets. This is again wrong. A child like sweet. A child likes sweet. Right? These mangoes are tasting sweet. Again, wrong. These mangoes taste sweet. Right? You can see in this example that we are following the verb and helping verbs according to the subject. That's it, dear student. That was something about present indefinite tense. I hope you understood. See some more example to understand this concept clearly. Thank you and have a great time ahead.